Before you start with this video, you should know a thing or two about the modes of the Mage skill. Please watch my tutorial Modes Explained Effective and Crystal Clear if you're new to modes. The link is in the description. In this video, we're going to learn how to create a convincing modal chord progression. Although we can't really speak of a progression, but rather of a chord sequence. We'll see that there's a difference between writing a tonal chord progression and a modal chord sequence. If we would play a scale where the distances between the notes are all the same, we'll end up with a bit of a strange and boring scale. It is called a whole tone scale. It's boring because there is absolutely no sense of homecoming. All the notes have the same weight. There's no tonal center. That's because there are no half-step intervals in this scale, which we do see in the major and minor scale. Those half-steps attract each other more than the notes with whole-step intervals. Those half-steps we experience as nice. We like to listen to it. The major scale, among others, is called a diatonic scale. This is a 7-note scale with 5 whole-steps and 2 half-steps. It's this kind of scale in which we can build chords on every note of the scale. We can then create sequences of chords that form chord progressions. When working with common major and minor scales, those chord progressions, or cadences as they are called, have one main purpose. They want to resolve to the first chord of the scale, which is the key center, and it's called the tonic. The tonic is like a homecoming chord. The theory behind chord progressions in major and minor keys is called functional harmony. We have to follow certain rules that find their origin in the 18th century. Now, with that rule set, we can create a progression which will lead evidently back to the tonic chord with hardly any effort. Now, tonic harmony is built on a 5-1 relationship between chords, like in this example. If we would follow this progression in the circle of fifths, which is a tonal system for all major and minor keys based on distances of 5 notes, you will notice that the chords move in a circular way, in intervals of fifths. In functional harmony, chords have one of 3 functions. The tonic function, which gives a home feeling. The dominant function creates a lot of tension and wants to resolve into the tonic. And the subdominant or predominant functions, they create a bit of tension and often precede the dominant before resolving into the tonic. In our chord progression we just played, we can see clearly the harmonic functions laid out. E minor and A minor are tonic functions. D minor is a subdominant. And G7 is a dominant chord, which leads to the tonic C. The dominant chord has a particular interval. It's called the tritone. It's a diminished fifth interval between the third and the seventh of the dominant chord. Now, a tritone creates so much tension that it wants to resolve inward or outward. Inward. Outward. It draws the music back to the tonic like metal to a magnet. We could say that a tonal chord progression has gravity. The gravitational point is the tonic, the first chord in the scale. The music around the tonic is pulled back to the tonic with each consecutive chord in the progression. Besides major and minor scales, there are 5 other modes of the major scale: Dorian, Phrygian, Lydian, Mixolydian, and Locrian. It's not so easy for our ears to recognize those modes. And they have a hard time recognizing those divergent scales and necessary chord progressions. These modes are treated with modal harmony. Other rules apply. Now, modal harmony has a lack of gravity. It almost floats, and the key center is not as strong as in tonal progressions. We must convince the listener that the root of the mode is the most home sound. Without this, the tune will simply begin to resemble a common major or minor harmony. We must be cautious though, because all the modes have a tendency to resolve to the relative minor or major key. So the Dorian, for example, becomes C major if we use the wrong chords from the Dorian scale. we will see later in this video that modal harmony is a different thing and needs a total different approach. I was thinking the other day, maybe we could compare tonal music to realistic paintings like the masterpieces of Rembrandt and Frans Hals. Logical, and we'll get what we expect, reality. But modal music resembles more the impressionistic art like Monet and Vincent van Gogh. They paint vague moods, which are not so obvious to interpret. Well, maybe, it's just a thought. So now let's analyze the chords in the seven modes of the major scale and see what the differences between these modes are. In this diagram you see all the modes of the C major scale, including the C major scale itself, at the top of the table, the C Ionian mode, which is in fact the C major scale, and the A Aeolian mode, better known as the A minor scale. Apart from the major and minor scale, the Ionian and Aeolian mode, every mode has a characteristic note, which triggers the sound of the mode. So Dorian has a raised sixth note. Phrygian has a flattened second note. Lydian has a raised fourth note. Mixolydian has a flattened seventh note. And Locrian has a flattened second and flattened fifth, which is characteristic for the Locrian mode. And even if we play just one chord, only the tonic, and we add that characteristic note to that chord, we'll get really the sound of that mode. In each scale or mode, we can form a chord on each note. If we do so, we end up with three types of chords. Major chords, a root, major third, and fifth. Minor chords, a root, minor third, and fifth. And a diminished chord, a root, minor third, and diminished fifth. In the Ionian mode, the major scale, we'll see the major chords on the first, fourth, and fifth note. A minor chord on the second, third, and sixth. And a diminished chord on the seventh note. To see the difference in chord configuration, we're going to do exactly the same with the next mode, the D Dorian mode, which is the second mode of the C major scale. We see a minor chord on the first, second, and fifth degree, a major chord on the third, fourth, and seventh degree, and a diminished chord on the sixth degree. So you can see that there's quite a difference between the Dorian mode and the major scale. The tonic is a minor chord, the fifth degree, called the dominant in functional harmony, is a minor chord instead of a major chord. And the seventh degree is a major chord instead of a diminished chord. Big difference, right? If we go on and do this for all the modes, we will see that every mode has a specific chord configuration, which is typical for that particular mode. The placement of major, minor, and diminished chords determines the sound of the modal cadence. So now, the big question. How do we write a modal chord sequence that actually works? Now we know what the chords are in the different modes, there are a couple of things we need to keep in mind when composing a modal harmony. First of all, functional harmony is not present at all. Second, we should put extra focus on the tonic chord of the mode to convince the listener that we are in a mode and not in a major or minor key. For instance, by repeating it a lot. By the way, those repeating chord patterns are called an ostinato. Then we should use characteristic notes for the particular mode as much as possible. These notes trigger our ears to believe that we are in a mode. We should be careful with the dominant and the diminished chords, since they bear the tritone. They want to resolve to their relative tonic. In modal harmony, each chord seems to float by itself as a standalone entity, not feeling the need to resolve into the tonic. It's a good idea to use chords that sound a little bit vague, like sus chords and added nine chords. Before we go any further, we need to ditch the tonal naming conventions like tonic, subdominant, and dominant. Instead, we will divide the chords in two groups. The modal tonic chords, chords that are built on the root note, and the modal cadence chords, which stray away from the modal tonic, but return right away to the tonic. The choice for the cadence chords is critical. use the wrong chords, like dominant and diminished chords, and our ears want to believe that we're back in the tonal harmony of the relative major key. To prevent that, we could use the adjacent modal chords, the lateral chords, to build around this tonic. So that will be the chord on the 7th degree and the chord on the 2nd degree. Now, those are the chords that are stepwise before and after the tonic. If we watch this diagram, we see all the modes with the root and lateral modal chords. Now, those chords give enough tension between the chord itself and the tonic, but do not have a strong sense of tonality. Here are some examples of using lateral modal chords in modal progressions. E Phrygian, E minor in conjunction with the D minor and F major chord. The note F is the characteristic note. F Lydian, F major in conjunction with E minor and G. B is the characteristic note. G Mixolydian, G major in conjunction with the F and A minor chord. The note F is the characteristic note. First of all, we will extend the triads to 7 chords to have a little more to work with. In this table, I've marked the no-go chords G7, a dominant chord with a tritone Bf, and the B minor flat 5, a dominant chord also with a tritone Bf. So, now let's have a look at the remaining chords, the 3rd, 4th, 5th, and 6th degree, and take D Dorian as an example. Now, the 3rd degree. In Dorian, the 3rd chord is a F major chord, and it has 2 notes in common with the D minor chord. Therefore, this chord is like an extension of the D minor chord and will sound a little like the tonic. Also a good option to put in our modal cadence. The chord on the 4th degree. In D Dorian, this is the G7 chord. It bears a characteristic note, the note B for the Dorian mode. But still, the G7 chord should be avoided, because it's a dominant and it bears a tritone. And that wants to resolve to the C major chord, as if C was the tonic and not D minor. So we can use the G chord, it has no tritone, but not the G7 chord, because it has a tritone. So now for the 5th degree, the A minor chord. Now the A minor chord has a tonal 5-1 relationship with the D minor chord, so that tends to functional tonality. It also lacks the characteristic note for this mode, the note B. So we have to be very careful with this one. Suspended versions like sus2 and sus4 and added 9 versions of this chord could work. The chord on the 6th degree in the D Dorian mode is the B minor 7 flat 5 chord, which has 3 notes in common with the modal tonic D minor. So it's like an extension of the D minor chord. But be aware, this half diminished chord has a tritone, which makes the B minor 7 flat 5 chord wants to resolve into a C major chord. So we lose the modal tonic D minor. Very tricky. So what we just did for the D Dorian goes for all the modes. The same rules apply. Now, let's recap the things that we saw in this tutorial so far, which you need to understand modal harmony. So first of all, major and minor scales are treated with tonal harmony, which is functional harmony, based on 5-1 chord relationships and tensions of chords which want to resolve to the tonic chord. The tonal harmony has a kind of gravity. The tonic is the gravitational point. Modal scales and harmony has nothing to do with functional harmony and do not have gravity. There's a kind of equality between these chords, although there's still a tonic chord. We will forget tonal naming conventions like tonic, subdominant, dominant. Instead, we have 2 chord groups, modal tonic and modal cadence chords. Now, in modal music, the order of chords isn't so important. The chords float around the tonic without having a need to resolve. You paint a mood with some chords from that mode. We must stay away from tonal harmony by avoiding the tritone in dominant chords, in dominant 7 chords. They tend to draw us back into tonal harmony. Now choose chords that bear the characteristic note of that mode. Use the tonic repeatedly so the ear gets used to the tonic. And don't use too many chords and keep it smooth and gentle. Try to create a little vague and ambiguous chord sounds. Now we still have 2 more tricks up the sleeve. There's a nice trick for every chord progression to work in modal tonality. And that's using the pedal tone. This note is always the root note and sounds throughout the whole progression. This forces the ear to consider this note being the modal root. So the danger of falling into tonal harmony is less present. Take this example for a modal Phrygian chord progression. Root E is used as a pedal tone, and the other chords float over this modal root note. And we can do the same in this Lydian example, F Lydian. The last interesting thing to do is making the chord you play slightly different by using suspended chords or added 9 chords or other version of a chord that sounds a little bit vague, like for instance in this Dorian modal progression. So this leaves us with some pretty ambiguous sounds that will emphasize the impressionistic quality of a modal progression. So now this concludes this tutorial, and I hope it was of some use for you and it gets you started with some amazing modal compositions. If you have any questions, please check my Patreon page and have fun with the things you've learned, and I'll see you next week.